Hi, this is Carolina from Healing Crystals Art Studio. Today we're gonna paint insects. I have a page here. Like all the exercises we do here in the studio, they're very free. There's no right and wrong way to do it. It's a way to find your style and whatever makes you happy and feel relaxed. Today we're gonna make some blobs of colors and then let the watercolor make their magic. Working wet on wet. This is the first layer. And then the second is make the details with a black marker or ink pen, or even a pencil if you don't have anything else. So let's start. I'm gonna use today my Moleskine watercolor journal. To help me out, I'm gonna put this here so the pages don't keep opening up. Okay, so like always, use the colors you have available in your dish or tray, or work directly from your pens. Just with a regular round brush. So let's start making the first one. The first one we're gonna make just a oval shape. Let's do it here, just an oval shape. With this wet, you can make like a pointy here. The end of the body of the insect. And then with this wet, you just put like a contrasting color. Let's put like a brown here. So just touching, so you just let the color run. Make like a shading area here. Maybe you can put something here. Then let's go with the second one. Let's do one red. So here, just use your imagination. You can follow my prompts, but you have some shape that comes to your mind, just go for it. I'm gonna make a circle, make a head here. Let's run some dark color to here, maybe in this part. There. And maybe just dry a little bit some area so it's lighter. Remember with your dry brush, you just remove. So for this to start drying like faster, you go back to the first one and start absorbing whatever color that is making like a ball, so it dries faster. Because you're gonna paint on top, right? I mean, draw on top the details. So this is about, at this point you learn how much you need to wait until it gets dry, how to apply the color like this with the point of your brush and just let the color flow freely and create those surprises.
Here you can make some shading again, with some color. Let's see. This is almost like drying, you can apply some contrasting. I'm gonna wait for here because this is too wet. I'm gonna make some other smaller creature. Maybe try like a kind of a ladybug. So you make just an oval in red. And then the smaller brush, just make it a black. And then give it this black to make it with the pen after. You always can do all these details with a very tiny brush on black when everything's dry. It's up to you. Let me see, it seems like this is dry in here. So let me add some color here.
Okay, so this is the second layer. After this dries completely, you go ahead and make details with pen, pencil, even with watercolor with a very thin brush if you want to practice. But this is fun to do just with a pen maybe. I use my Microns always. So let's do some. So for this one, I kind of like, and this is again, this is very free. This is just, it's your imagination run and create your own insects. I'm gonna make maybe this. I hope you like this exercise, very free. You can even make some details with, now that it's dry, with more watercolors. So post it on Instagram with the hashtag healingcrystalsart so I can see them. See you next video.